So let's continue with our SharePoint quick questions and answers video session, and let's take up question number 17. How can we display ACX control in SharePoint? Just to revise, what are basically ACX control? You know, if in case you are a fresher or in case you are a newcomer to ASP.NET, ACX control helps us to provide reusability by using the drag and drop mechanism. In other words, you create a control or you create a reusable functionality. And normally these functionalities are visual functionality. So for example, you can create a login.acx control and you can drag and drop that control again and again in ASP.NET pages. So you can say that ACX control are visual controls which can be reused across pages, right? So now let's see that how we can create a ACX control and how we can use the same in SharePoint pages. So the first step we need to do is that we need to create a ACX control. So let's first do that. Here's my ACX control. This ACX control basically has two buttons and one label. So if you click on click me, it basically sets a value to the LBL display. And if you click on click to clear the text, it basically clears off the label. So if you look at the source code, you will see that the CMD set basically calls a set text method, which basically sets the label. And the CMD set clear basically calls a clear text method and it basically clears the label. So that's a, this is a simple ACX control which I have, and let's see that how we can use this control in SharePoint. So now we have completed two steps. We have completed one of the first step. We have created the control, and one point to note is that you need to name the file as .acx. So it is a bit different than normally what we do for ASPX pages. So the extension of ACX controls are named as .acx, right? So we have done with the first step. Now let's look at the second step. We need to copy this ACX file in the control templates directory. So basically, we need to copy this file to the ACX directory of SharePoint. Now the ACX directory of SharePoint is in C program files, common files, Microsoft Shared, web server extension, /12/template/control templates. And you can see I've created a folder here, my user control, so that I don't get confused with the other ACX which are currently existing here of SharePoint. And I have pasted the myusercontrol.acx in the directory, right? So now that's done. And another point to note here is that this ACX control doesn't use a behind code. It's an inline code. It doesn't use a behind code. In case your ACX control is using a behind code, you need to register the behind code using GAC, right? So now that we are done with the second step, let's look at the third step. We need to refer the ACX file in the page. So I've created a page called as .asp, a page using custom control.aspx, and I'm referring this control by using my register attribute. I've given a name to it called as my user control prefix. This is a tag prefix name, and I've given a tag name for it so that I can refer by these two names in the page. The third attribute is a very important attribute, and this is where is your ACX file lying. So currently it's lying in the control templates, myusercontrol.ascx. I have given a tilde here because basically this is the virtual directory name, right? Now I am referring this user control in my page by the tag prefix and the tag name. So in this way, I am referring this control in my ASPX page. So the first step what I did is I registered it. Second step, I'm using it. So this is the place when we refer this my user control prefix and the control name, we are basically going to create an object here. So when the page initializes, it will basically create an object of it here. All right. So now we have done with the third step. The final step is where we need to copy this page or we need to provision this page. So what I'm going to do is that I'm going to just copy this page to the layouts directory and display it and see how it works. So this is my layouts directory, and I've copied the page here, page using custom control.aspx. Okay, so now that we are done, now let's see that how our page looks like. So let me run my site. I've actually hosted this in Learn SharePoint. Administrator and my password. And to refer the page, I need to give _ layouts. I'll directly refer it so that you know. So that's my custom control, you can see, which is being used inside the page using custom control.aspx. Now if I click here, it just sets a value to the control, and if I click back, it clears the value. Now normally if you look at the use of ASCX are when you're going to use visual controls, visual reusable controls like the calendar control, like a data grid control, like left menu bar or right menu bar. So in those instances, you would like to create ASCX files. So I hope that this session was useful, and see you in the coming session. Just a point to be noted, all these source codes are available in questpondvd.com. In case you have bought the DVD, you can get the source code in the source code folder itself in the DVD. So thanks for hearing me. I hope that this session was useful, and see you in the forthcoming sessions.